After his team lost in the finals, LeBron James spent much of the summer searching for answers. Many of you know that he went down to Houston to work with Hakeem Olajuwon on low post moves, but he also wanted to pick the brains of some of the NBA's greatest winners. So he scheduled meetings with the likes of Magic Johnson, Larry Bird, Isaiah Thomas, and Michael Jordan, as well as Olajuwon. He could only meet with Johnson and Thomas because the lockout rules forbade him from talking to team executives Bird and Jordan. James says he was looking for perspective from each of those multiple title winners to see if there was anything in terms of preparation or focus that he was not doing. And while he enjoyed his time with all of them guys, he really enjoyed his time with Olajuwon. He says the two spent more time talking about fatherhood and family than they did about basketball. Kevin?
Well, he's obviously a player who thinks a lot. He tried to revamp his mid-range game. 5 seconds to shoot right here. Mike Bibby takes the place of Davis. Fields works on Wade. And got it to go. That's a good-looking shot. That stops a 9-0 run. I noticed that he didn't talk to Kobe Bryant in terms of what it takes to win a championship.
Well, he was on the same Olympic team with him, and he could have actually spoken with our own Shaquille O'Neal. But, you know, the average fan that's at home watching this is saying, are you kidding me? This is the most physically gifted guy in our game. And for whatever reason, you left Cleveland, and you had every right to do that, to join arguably one of the top 5 players in Dwayne Wade and Chris Bosh, top 10 or 15 player. And now you're reaching out to Hall of Famers to see what it takes. Enough is enough. Go out and actually do it on your own. What do you need more help for? That's my only question about that.
Foul called on Chris Bosh as Chalmers leaves. They bring in Mike Miller, does Miami. On the other side of the coin, you could say, hey, he's just doing his due diligence. He wants to tap into some of the guys that have been there before. He's not won a championship. I don't know if I can fault him. Stoudemire takes it in. He's like a steamroller going right into Bosh. That's a great matchup, the Stoudemire-Bosh matchup. So what do you say to that? Say,
well, hey, just I'm not faulting him. What I'm saying is you're getting ready to be a 3-time MVP because he's going to win it this year. Guys should be calling you. I don't remember Michael Jordan when he was getting his head beat in by the Bad Boys, calling someone up and saying, how do I get by Detroit? I didn't see Isaiah calling anyone when he couldn't get by the Boston Celtics. You figure it out and you go on and actually do it. I love LeBron James. He is the best and most physically gifted player in our game. He doesn't need help. Guys need to be calling him instead of him going out and researching help.
Well, you can't argue with the production. He's had another terrific season as Bosh will check out with his second foul.